Midway Tower, Air Coop 99055, Mayday, Mayday, Mayday.
Air Coop, Midway, go ahead.
Gas turbine engines are the miracle machines of our age, which compress the air from the atmosphere and burn it with fuel and create a reverse propulsion force by rapidly blowing out the resulting gases. The fact that the desired high speeds and high altitudes could not be achieved in piston engines and propeller aircrafts led scientists to develop higher performance engines. In the 1914, British scientists Frank Whittle and German scientist Hans von Ohain have been working on a gas turbine engines as parallel with each other. As a result of these studies, the PowerJet W1 radial flow engine developed by Frank Whittle was used for the first time in Gloster G-49 aircraft. German scientist Hans von Ohain was developed Junkers Jumo 004, which can be considered as the ancestor of the axial flow engines used today. And then these engines were installed on Messerschmitt MA-262 aircraft. These aircrafts were taken their place in history as the first jet engine aircraft that were mass-produced and actively used in air wars. With the end of the Second World War, axial flow gas turbine engines have been preferred to be used in commercial, civil and military aviation. Due to advantages of axial flow engines over radial flow engines such as higher pressure and speed. These engines have been used in civil aviation, enabled the development of turbofan engines known as high bypass engines. In military aviation, supersonic speeds have been achieved with a fan and afterburner system added to the engines, and the types known as low bypass ratio engines have emerged. Now let's try to understand the axial flow gas turbine engine in its simplest form. Axial flow gas turbine engines basically consist of five main parts. These are air intake that allows atmospheric air to be taken into the engine. Compressor that increases the pressure and temperature of the atmospheric air. The combustion chamber that the compressed air is mixed with fuel and obtain gas energy. The turbine where the compressor is rotated by converting gas energy into the mechanical energy. It is the exhaust where thrust is obtained as a result of passing the gases coming out of the engine through a narrow nozzle and accelerating the gases. In fact, many changes occur in the engine in terms of pressure, temperature and speed during the operation of the engine. These changes are related to the laws of Charles Boyle, Brayton, Dalton and Newton. Pressure of the air taken from atmosphere through the compressor increases at rate of approximately 3 or 4 psi in each stage of compressor that gets more and more narrower. Increasing pressure means decreasing of air volume. This situation, which can be expressed as compression, is necessary for the formation of sufficient gas energy in the combustion chamber. Burning of atmospheric air in the combustion chamber takes place at constant pressure as required by Brayton's law. The pressure of the burning gases decreases a little, but the volume increases a little with the effect of the combustion. The higher combustion temperature, the larger volume of gases. The turbine takes the kinetic energy in expanding gases. Most of the pressure energy of the gases entering the turbine drops suddenly while passing through the turbine stage. In the exhaust, the pressure of the gases does not change significantly and follows a parallel and constant course in general. When we look at the temperature parameter in the compressor, the temperature of the air entering the compressor increases significantly with the decrease in the volume and the increase of its pressure. The temperature rise depends on the number and size of the compressor stage. Increase in temperature increases the energy of the air and makes it easier to burn. The highest temperature values in the engine are reached in the combustion chamber result of burn. However, the temperature decreases a little with the effect of the cooling air taken from compressor in secondary area of the combustion chamber. because of the loss of energy in each turbine stage and the cooled of the turbine elements. The temperature of the burnt gases entering the turbine gradually decreases. Although there's a slight decrease in the temperature of the gases in the exhaust part, it remains generally constant. When we examine the graph in terms of the speed parameter, we can see that the speed of the air taken into the compressor is reduced for an efficient combustion. Depending on the speed of the aircraft, the air entering the compressor at high speeds is slowed down at each stage and reduced to 25 meters per second. With the burn occurring in the combustion chamber and the increase in the volume of the air, or in other words, the expansion of the gases, the speed of the gas begins to increase again. The gases that accelerate even more with the structure of the turbine inlet nozzle and stator vane enable the rotation of the turbine rotor part. At this point, although their energy decreases a little, the speed of gases at the turbine outlet is quite high. The velocity of the gases coming out of the convergent area of the exhaust nozzle increases in accordance with the Bernoulli principle. In this case, thrust occurs, which we will explain in detail later. In fact, the forward motion of aircraft is related to the force generated by the velocity of the gases exiting the exhaust. This situation is explained by the Newton's third law of motion. According to law, for every force, there is always an equal and opposite reaction force. When we adopt this law to aircrafts, it causes a reaction force in opposite direction of the impact force produced by the exhaust gases. This force is expressed as thrust. Let's take a look at this experiment to better understand this topic. When we inflate a balloon and fix it on a straight line, the compressed air inside the balloon will want to exit from the narrow mouth similar to the exhaust nozzle of the balloon, and as a result, the accelerating air will create an impact force. The body of the balloon will respond to this as a forward motion. Aircraft reaction force. In aviation, it is expressed as a thrust force. As long as the thrust force is greater than the drag forces, the aircraft moves forward with acceleration. If forces of thrust and drag force acting on an aircraft are equal, the aircraft stays in balance and moves in the air at a constant speed, as you can see in the animation. There is no increase or decrease in the speed of the aircraft. If the thrust force is less than the drag forces, this time the aircraft will start to glide or lose altitude. This situation is actually related to the fact that the lift forces occurring in the wings are directly proportional to the thrust forces. I hope I was explaining how a gas turbine engine works with this general information. In our next videos, we will get to know the elements in the gas turbine engine internal structure more closely. See you again.